everyone, and welcome to round two of the GT300 Triple Mix Championship. We're at Monza, as you can probably tell by the background footage, and I hope you enjoyed the race-free highlights from the Red Bull Ring. As you saw, it was a very close finish, but unlike the other race programs, we're not going to look at the race results, as we did see them right at the end of the highlight footage. We're actually going to look at the championship positions and points and where people stand at the moment in the championship as we look towards the two races that are going to be happening here at Monza. So they should be on the screen now, and as you can see, we have GTP Pasm right at the top of the table with 186 points. Consistency paying off there for Pasm, followed by TNR Philo in second place. Only 2 points separating those drivers, and Philo isn't racing at Monza, so Pasm can only extend that lead from Philo. Or could Bambi, who's in third place, actually catch Pasm up a little bit? In fourth, we have Mr. Racing Line on 164 points, joint fourth with GTP Roma 2629. Then in sixth place, we have Sig 1611, who had an incident in race one, which was under investigation, and he got penalised a little bit in that race. So he's now in sixth place with 158 points. And then we have JF Rod 52. With 156 points, 22 points separating those drivers. You can see how close this championship actually is now. As we then look at GTP Oz, who's in 8th place with 144. And then in joint 9th, we have GTP Duchy and Nail 27 on 134 points. In joint 11th, again, a lot of joint places in this. We have GTP Patrick 1, and we also have Napalm LT. And then on joint 114 points, TNR Zigan, who missed, or TNR Zigan, whichever way you want to pronounce it, who missed the first race at Red Bull Ring. He's got a lot of catching up to do, and he's currently on 114 points, along with Gravitron, who had a couple of nightmare races in the second and third race, so Gravitron will be looking to improve. We then have Mad Max in 15th place, who made the last race at the Red Bull Ring. So there are your championship standings. As you can see, it's very close, which means the Monza races should be close, and it should make for some tactical decisions. So a little bit about the Monza event. The races are now 30 minutes long rather than 20, and we only have two races, unlike the Red Bull Ring where we had three races. We also have mandatory pit stops, so you have to make a pit stop, which is going to bring in quite a bit of tactics here with slipstream and everything else in there, traffic. So your qualifying is key, and then your strategy is also key, and we look forward to seeing that, of course. Now, because we have a few more drivers entering this round of the championship, we're actually going to split into two races. So you'll get the live race, which is the main race, Lobby 1, and you'll get the full commentary and live footage of that. And then after that, we'll see the highlights of Room B, essentially, and what actually happened in there. So next up in the driver profiles is somebody who had an eventful two races at Red Bull Ring. Didn't quite make the first race, but I'm sure we'll have an eventful three races with the two here at Monza and one at Silverstone, and that driver is TNR Zigan. So, TNR Zigan, age 15. And uses the Logitech G29, so a racing wheel, as his controller. His favourite car is the Porsche 918, and his favourite colour to race in is either light blue or black. Finally, his favourite moment in Gran Turismo is winning the Drivers' Championship in the GTP Endurance Series. So that has been TNR Zigan. And the qualifying begins for the first race at Monza. So, who are we on? Let's have a look. We're going to jump straight to Bambi, who is currently third in the championship, and he is in a Subaru Impreza. Similar to the first races at the Red Bull Ring, we have qualifying, which is a little longer this time, as it's a bit of a longer track, as we'll watch Bambi on this first lap of Monza. He crosses the line. We've got a lot of long straights here, so car setup is very key here. There'll be differences in downforce. As he comes up to the first chicane, brakes around 130 metres, comes in. How does he do this? perfectly. Great first chicane there for Bambi. Already ahead of the field if we have a look behind. Easily ahead of everybody as he goes around the Curva Grande and approaches the second chicane. We'll see how he does when he comes up to this second chicane. These chicanes are quite tricky, especially in the exit of this one with the gravel trap being so close. Once again, a perfect exit. A bit slidey. That could be the lag, but that was pretty well done. We've got Lesmo 1 and 2 coming up. You need a late apex, as he does there. Doesn't quite hit it full on, but it still exits the corner quite well. Comes up to the second one of these. Just misses it slightly again. Doesn't use too much of the exit as well, but Bambi is still ahead of the rest of the field, which suggests Bambi is going to get the first fastest lap here. As he comes up to... I find this section quite complex, really, actually. It depends how he does it. Nails the first part. It's about all about the exit here for the long straight. Doesn't use too much of the exit again as he heads down to the Parabolica. Still looking very nice for Bambi so far. We'll see his lap time and then we'll see what people are doing on splitwise as well. As he comes up to the Parabolica, again, it's sort of like a late apex and then it just lures you around. And, ooh, he's very close to the grass there. Sort of pulled himself back a little bit. As now he heads towards the start-finish straight to end the first lap, and then we'll see where Bambi is. Looking behind, he's well ahead of the field in this Subaru Impreza. And a 1:49.7 is currently the lap to beat. JF Rod 52 goes to second, Pasm goes to third. Oh no, Sig goes to third, jumps Pasm there. Oh, Bambi goes, oh wow, we've got a big change there. Big change, sorry, Zygon's gone into pole position, not Bambi down. DEPR has gone into third place. Oh, Meisterfetz jumps everybody and goes straight into lead. Let's have a look at these lap times and then we'll have a look at what the cars everybody's using. So if you have a look at the times here, we've got Meisterfetz fastest in sector 1, Zygon faster in sector 2, and then Meisterfetz fastest in sector 3, which these are 1:49.4 essentially. Very close between the top two, with then Bambi being a few tenths behind. Let's have a look at the cars that everybody is using. So we'll start off right at the top of the field. Meisterfetz, who's in the RX-7. If we have a look at Zygon in the Lexus. And then it's Bambi in the Impreza. So we have all three cars in the top three. So it shows you how close this is. We have DEPR in the Subaru Impreza, a nice orange colour there. GF Rod 52 in a Lexus. Sig in a Lexus. What is Pasm in? What car? The Impreza. Roma's in the Lexus. Dutch is in the Impreza. We have Oz in the RX-7. Pulling away a Sig there. And then we have Fisher in the green Impreza. So that's your grid so far, as we're going to jump to the leader and see if he improves on his lap. Oh, he's a bit further behind most people, actually. So we'll jump to live timing and have a look at how people are doing as they approach the end of the lap. So Bambi's about to cross the line first, and he does a 1:49.1. Puts himself straight onto pole position there. Few changes down, GF Rod's dropped two places. Sigan also changing place. Zygon's just gone up, 1:48.9. Now it's all about what Meisterfetz can do. Let's jump to Meisterfetz. Let's see if he can get into that 1:48 bracket. Doesn't do it. So, at the moment, it's Zygon from Bambi, then Meisterfetz. This is the last lap they will have to qualify for the race. We then have DEPR in 4th place, followed by Pasm, our championship leader, in 5th place so far. Roma in 6th place, followed by Dutchie, and then JF Rod 52. We'll follow Meisterfetz round for this last lap, and see, we can hear the RX-7 and that unique engine, and tone it's got, really. It's a very, very unique sound engine. Approaches his second chicane. How is he going to do this? He must have had a mistake on the previous lap. First part done. Ooh, runs very close to that gravel. Doesn't quite go in, so he's still got his lap all working out for him so far. Manages to get closer to the apex than Bambi did on his first lap. Come up to the second Lesmos. Oh! Gets a bit sideways. I think that's a mistake. I think that's the end of his lap there. So let's jump to live timing. Let's see if anyone's on the purple sector. Now, okay, so we've got Bambi and Zygon. I think it's going to be very close between these two, you know. Who is going to get this pole position? As we will jump to Bambi first, if we can get there pretty quickly. Where's Bambi? Let's see the lap time Bambi does get from this. Is he after anything under a 148.9? What's he going to do? He doesn't do it. So I do believe that Zygen's come in the pits. Very interesting. Maybe testing out the pit strategy, as there are mandatory pits in this. So Meisterfett is coming round. He's got to beat a 148.9. But remember, he made that mistake in the middle of the lap. And it doesn't look like he's going to do it here. Doesn't quite do it. In fact, I can imagine he was probably a bit disappointed there, as he has only just lost out there on that time, and he made that big mistake in the lap. DPR now going very slowly, as obviously the qualifying is finished. Passams ended up in a wall. Who have we got here? Sig having a bit of a practice, so all well and good. Dutchy stopped on track. Oz has stopped. We got JF Rod 52, who's hit the barrier along with Passam, and we have Fisher in the lime green Impreza, who is rounding out our 11 drivers. We do have two rooms, remember? So we have 11 drivers in this one. I'm unsure how many are in the other one, but we will see the highlights of that room after this race. So that's qualifying done, as we prepare for the race now. Now that is 30 minutes, remember, it's not 20 like Red Bull Ring, but we only have two races here, so it becomes a bit more complex. We have mandatory pit stops, so it's becoming a bit more tactical as well. And remember, it's car choices again. You can't use this car again once you've raced it. So we'll just wait for it to load now. Downforce again is going to play a really key part in this. You know, do you go with a very low downforce and have problems in the corners? Yeah, and then high downforce in the corners and problems on the straight. And then hopefully the slipstream will get you. But here's your qualifying positions. We have Zygen, then Bambi, Meisterfetz, DEPR, then Roman Passam. And then on row 4 we have Sig and Dutchy, row 5 GTPRs and JF Rod 52, and then finally Fisher. So we're straight on to the pole position man, Zygen. Let's get all the information up so we can see what everybody is doing as we wait for the lights to go green. And away we go. And it looks like Bambi has had a cracking start, straight into the lead. We've got positions changing further down the grid. Looks like JF Rod and Dutchy are having a battle down there. Dutchy must have had a bad start because he's dropping position. Sig has had a great start to come into the first chicane. It's going to be a bunch up here. Slight contact there. We're all through, I think. Bambi keeping that lead there. Dutchy's gone right to the back of the grid. Fisher's made two places up in that first chicane as we watch Bambi and Zygen as they come through the grand curve. Or curve grande, should I say. So come to the chicane. What's going to happen here? He's going to go for a dive bomb, perhaps. A bit early in the race to go for dive bombs, I would say. Doesn't quite do that. Everyone's going through fine. Takes up a bit of the dirt. We've got a bit of sideways action, a bit further back. We'll jump a bit further down the grid. Let's see what's happening. We've got Sig trying to chase Passam. And we've got a bit of a gap already in between each of the cars so far as we go down. Meisterfetz down in fifth place. He's lost a few positions during the start of that race. JF Rod 52 there. We have Roma and Oz, DPR, Fisher and Dutchy. Now, is there any movement in this complex of corners? No. Using a lot of curb there, Dutchy. Just going to get a lot of speed out of the edge. Someone picking up a bit of gravel up front. As we jump to Bambi, and we'll go to the TV cameras just so we can see what the field is doing. Bambi again in the same colours he was in last week at the Red Bull Ring in all three races. But looks like he is commanding that lead so far. We're going to have a bit of slipstream down the straight though, so is it that Zygen's going to come at him and go for a brake manoeuvre down the inside as we get towards the chicane? Oh, we've got a bit moving further back. Who is that? And it's Sig, and Meisterfetz is taking that position from Sig. Sig will have to come in behind unless he goes for a really late braking manoeuvre. No, he doesn't. It looks like Meisterfetz might have outbroke himself a little bit. No, he keeps it on the track, keeps it on the track. Smithy, we have, I believe that was Zygen getting a bit of the gravel on the exit. It's going to give Passam a bit of momentum. We have Sig right behind Meisterfetz now. Is he going to go through it through the Curva Grande? Trying to go for the inside. There's not quite enough room there, Sig. Is he going to go for a dive bomb on the left-hand side? That's another talking point as we come up to the chicane. It's very hard to get an overtaking maneuver done here. And Meisterfetz keeps that position. Oh, slight contact! Bit of a tank slapper there for Meisterfetz. Now, Seger was warned from the last race with that issue with Bambi as well. Meisterfetz now on the left-hand side. Oh, a bit sideways! And JFRod takes position. Oh, it's all kicking off in front of us. Oh, my... JFRod nearly hits Sig, but Sig avoids him and goes into Barry anyway. Bit of contact there from Meisterfetz there. Probably not happy. As we look now from behind Sig and look at see if Meisterfetz is going to make a move. That initially was caused by Sig, of course. He just slightly tapped him on the chicane. Meisterfetz going down the right-hand side of Sig. And he's actually taken that position. What a move! What a move by Meisterfetz to take that position from Sig there. Now he's going to chase after JF Rod 52 to try and get that position. Oh, he's made a bit of a mistake on the exit. Sig's coming back at him now. But Meisterfetz has the initial slipstream. It's now going to move towards Sig. But Meisterfetz has obviously got the initial momentum. Fischer's making a move further back. We just stay on this battle at the moment. Meisterfetz keeps that position now. Well, looks like Sig's got a bit of momentum again. Is he going to go for the... He's going for the left-hand side. Meisterfetz staying on the right. But who's going to get the slipstream here? They're both going to have to compete for it. Nope, Meisterfetz has kept that position. Now, this is where we'll see about downforce. The RX-7 is expected to be the quickest from the information I've got. But, it's definitely pulling away. So, Meisterfetz has kept that position. Fischer is moving up the grid there. Oh, very close on DEPR. We can see a bit more of the battle up front as well. Now, Fischer started in 11th place. He's now up to 8th place, so he's making some good progress here. Must have had a bit of a bad time in qualifying. Didn't quite look at what was happening with Fischer in the qualifying. He's lost a bit of ground to DEPR there. If we have a look behind, we've got Roma right behind Fischer here. Is Roma going to make a move? Let's have a look at this. Oh, gets very close. Slight tap, I think. He's had to miss the curb there, but that was because of contact. Oh, Roma's hit the gravel as well. If we go a bit further back now. Nope. Oz and Dutchy also competing. Right, we're going to jump back up the field. We'll have a look what Bambi and Zygen are doing. Not been with these for a while. Zygen's very close here. Let's jump to Zygen. He's going to go for any overtake. He's got the momentum. He's going down the inside. It's not a really good overtake. Oh, he pulls back in. I was going to say, it's not a very good overtaking place, that. It's just the way the complex of curves work. Now, if he gets the momentum off here, he could have a chance. Fischer moved up to 7th. He is really making some progress back further down the field. And Meisterfetz has got that position from Sig. We'll jump back to that battle shortly, but we've got Zygen really close to Bambi here, fighting for the lead of the race. Bambi goes a bit wide here. Zygen is on the inside. And it's side by side as we go down the straight. Let's jump to the TV camera for this. This should look absolutely amazing. Side by side, still side by side. Looks like the Subaru's got a bit extra speed. Is Zygen has to come in behind. Is he going to jump back out and go for a break? No, he doesn't. Fischer's now up to 6th place. What is happening with Fischer? We're going to have to go back to Fischer here. It's overtaken Sig on the straight, and now he's got the battle between... Oh, Meisterfetz has taken JF Rod 52 there as well. So a lot of slipstream action going on. We know the RX-7 is the quickest after we saw Meisterfetz move ahead of Sig earlier on the straight. So now we're going to stay with Fischer and see what if Fischer can get past JF Rod 52. Fischer, new to the race, of course. JF Rod 52, a little bit more experience with racing all three races at the Red Bull Ring. But he is being caught by Fischer. Ooh, makes a slight mistake. Holds him behind, though. As we look behind, Sig has now got pressure from DEPR there. Oh, there's been a mistake up front. Meisterfetz has had a big, big mistake on Lesmo 1. They've all gone into him. Sig and DPR go straight through as well. Fischer's got damage to his engine. He's going to have to pit this lap. He's going to have to pit. We'll have to have a look at the other cars in the... as JF Rod 50 doesn't have damage. Sig doesn't have damage, but Sig has now got momentum. Is he going to keep this position? It's very close. You really can't do this, guys. You can't go three wide down into this corner. And somehow they're all getting through this. And Sig gets the position. DEPR fails him behind. And then JF Rod 52 loses 2 places there. And Roma is now on the outside. A little bit off the track there. But he's got a bit more momentum as we're going to follow this battle from this point. Roma's now got that position on the leaderboard. DEPR goes to the left-hand side of Sig. He's going to get this coming into the Parabolica. Six stars position, DPR still on the outside, slight contacts, nothing to worry about there, and Sig does keep the position. Roma still on the inside of JF Rod 52, as they come through the Parabolica. Now they're both in Lexuses, so we've got to see slipstream, we've got DPR with the slipstream now of Sig as well. And DPR is going to get that position. They both have slipstream behind, so that's purely downforce. And DEPR definitely gets a position. Roma and JFR 52 still at it. And Roma gets it on the inside. That is Roma's position. Sixth place to Roma. Oh, a bit sideways on the exit. Got to be careful. That is Roma. Oh, up front, we've had a change of position for the lead. Bambi has lost position to Zygen. That must have been down the straight as well. And Zygen has now the lead. A bit of a scruffy exit there of the second chicane. Just going to have to watch out for Bambi as we go through the first Lesmo. I imagine Meister Fetz must have just hit the inside. There's a slight barrier there. Must have hit that and actually spanned the car, which is when all those guys piled into him. And if we have a look at positions of cars, where is Meister Fetz? He's currently in 11th place, as Bambi is currently lost position. Oh, he's in the gravel. Doesn't have any damage. Now, the only person who did have damage was... Who was it? I think it was... Who was trying to find the guy with damage? Oh, it's Fisher, wasn't it? Now that damage is gone. So he's now back working. And he's approaching JF 52. So some of that hard work he did to get up those positions, going to have to do again. We'll see what he does on the straight. He's got a bit of slipstream. He's right behind JF 52. Could go for a move at the Parabolica. Definitely got slipstream now. Moves to the left hand side of JF 52. Has a momentum. Now it's a slight slipstream off Roma, I imagine. And that's if he breaks later than JFR 52. No, JFR 52 breaks later. Slight contact. Fisher keeps the position. Very close to the grass, but does keep it. Now, is he in... I don't think he's close enough to get the slipstream off Roma. We'll have to see as he goes down the straight as we... Oh, Pazm is in the pits. We have our first pitter. Pazm has pitted early. Now, it's very interesting. And yes, he must be in a slight slipstream. Right, we're going to have a look at Pazm in the pits. He's already leaving the pits, believe it or not, so he's going to come out. That's how much ground Meister Fetz has lost. Pazm is already out the pits, and Pazm can see Meister Fetz already. So Meister Fetz has a lot of work to do, and Pazm is in a good position at the moment. I do wonder why he has pitted that early, but we'll see later on in the race. Maybe it was a very tactical decision. We'll jump up a bit further in the field. Bambi still in second place. We'll go to Sig. Sig has lost ground a little bit there. So the main battle is... Well, Fisher did take JF Rod 52. So now Fisher's going to be chasing Roma. And we'll have a look at this gap at the end of this lap to see if there's actually any movement that's going to happen here. Sig, it looks like he's actually catching it. We're going to jump to Sig. Looks like he's catching DEPR. Remember, there's a lot of straights on here. So a slipstream can help you carry on and catch people up. As we approach... Now he's definitely getting under braking. So depending on setups as well, you got to remember tyres could potentially be an issue. It's a 30-minute race. You want to pit. You want your tyres to last as long as possible and good grip. So we'll have to be careful of that. We're going to jump to the leaders as they come on the start-finish straight. Let's have a look at Bambi and Zygen. Zygen goes for the pits. Bambi stays out. Tactical decisions there by Bambi. Stays out. Zygen pits. So Zygen must be covering Pazm. And now it's time for Bambi to try and put in those all-important laps to try and actually gain some time from Zygen and come out still in the lead. As we're now going to jump further back. There's Impreza. Looks like it is faster than the Lexus because this is slipstream and Sig doesn't look like he's actually catching that much. That could be due to downforce as well. We'll have to see. But I'll tell you what we are going to do. We're going to jump to Pazm and see if we can see... Oh, there's Zygen right in front. So Zygen... keeps the position ahead of Pazm. It's going to be very close coming down to the chicane, though. Oh, it's going to be... Now, Pazm is on warmer tyres, and he's now used to the grip after pitting. This is going to be very close. Zygen's going to be very careful not to be held up by Meister Fetz. Now, Bambi is also out on his own. Ooh, he's getting all very close now. Some tactics are definitely coming in. Pazm has a little bit of work to do to catch up to Zygen. And Zygen is getting quite close to Meister Fetz. This actually could help him if he uses a slipstream, but if he gets held up at all, he's got a bit of an issue. So let's jump to Bambi. Bambi's all out on his own. He's got quite a considerable gap back to DPR now. Obviously, that incident earlier on with Meister Fetz on Lesmo 1 would have helped this gap. And let's actually have a look at the times. So, fastest lap is down with Fischer. So, Fischer must have definitely had a bad qualifying, but Fischer is definitely on the move again. Now, is Bambi going to pit? Let's jump to Bambi. We're going to look here now. He's going to try and cover Zygen, I imagine. Does he come in the pits? He doesn't. He stays out. This is getting very interesting. Bambi stays out. Let's go a bit further back. We now have DPR and Sig. DPR goes for the pits. Sig carries on. So let's jump. Let's jump a bit further back. Fischer carries on. DFR 52 carries on. Roma carries on. Dutchie's in the pits. Oz carries on. Meister Fetz comes in the pits. It's what I expected. And Zygen, obviously they've pitted. Passen's pitted. Now we're going to see, does anybody come out anywhere near these guys? DPR is probably going to be the closest to Passen, but nope. Nowhere near. So now it's about all about the pit stops. DPR's already left. You have Dutchie and Meister Fetz. Meister Fetz gets dropped down early. Ooh, this is going to be close. Isn't released. Ooh, I thought Meister Fetz was going to leave early there, but didn't. So, he's got a considerable gap to Dutchie, so we're going to jump a bit further up now. Let's have a look at Fischer. I imagine Fischer was catching Sig. Oh, I thought he was. Looks like Sig has some considerable distance to Fischer. Obviously, that damage earlier on to the engine slowed him down quite a lot. And I imagine Fischer wants to catch up to Sig and actually overtake him. And that would be a good finish for Fischer for that first race, especially with that qualifying. 11th position qualifying. Currently to third, but obviously we've got, that's not actual net gains yet because Fischer still has to pit. Now, if Bambi pits, we're going to jump straight to Zygen and actually follow Zygen all the way through this, the remaining part of the circuit, to see if Zygen comes out. We're going to keep this a surprise to see if Bambi does pit. I imagine he will pit this lap. I do imagine so. No, he's carried on. Bambi has carried on. So he's keeping going. In fact, we could do maintain that. Sigurd's now pitted. Fischer carries on. Right, okay, so let's have a look at actual gaps. So Bambi, last lap, 149.4 basically. We've got Zygen, who is being held up here. This is working out well for Bambi. Zygen did a 151.7 last lap. Oh, there we go. It's just updated. Zygen did a 148.8. He's catching back. This is actually detrimental for Bambi, for him to stay out. Passen is actually done the fastest lap now with 148.22. These guys must be so close down here. Let's jump to... Oh, there's a battle up ahead. There's Zygen and Oz. Now, he doesn't want to stay in that for too long, does Zygen? He wants to get past and quickly get ahead. But Passen is on a charge as well. Now, if Passen can... he's going to actually approach Oz in a quite difficult position, because Lesmo 1 and 2 aren't the best for overtaking. Depends how fast he does catch him up. We'll stay with Passen and just have a look. He is catching Oz very quickly, though. We'll have to be careful. But this is detrimental to Bambi. Bambi has to pit this lap. If he doesn't pit this lap, he's going to lose second position to Passen. And Passen's tactical decision to pit early has really helped him out. Oh! Runs fairly wide there. And Oz is keeping up with Zygen at the moment, just losing a little bit of ground. And Passen's made a mistake, so he could catch him on the back straight. Though Oz is going to have the slipstream of Zygen. I imagine Oz will want to pit this lap, though. So let's jump to Bambi. Let's see if Bambi pits. Is he pitting? Bambi's not pitting. Still not pitted. He's got to be careful. Is Fischer going to pit? Looks like Fischer is going to pit now. Now, Fischer was fighting with DEPR. Let's jump to DEPR. And let's see if Fischer has actually gained any positions from this. Staying out. The remainder are pitting. So it's only Bambi really staying out. And Oz has stayed out as well, actually. Now, where's DEPR and Fischer going to come out? Now, Fischer's definitely left his pit box and the arrows. There's Fischer, so DPR keeps that position. Where is Fisher going to come out? Let's have a look. Sig goes past. It looks like Fisher might have gained a bit of ground. No. Sig's on the straight, of course. Anybody else coming? Nobody else is coming, so Fisher has 7th place. Quite far ahead of JF Rod 52. Oh, he runs slightly wide of the first chicane. That'll have slowed him down a lot. New tyres, of course. Right, we're going to jump to Pasm and Oz, because Pasm has just overtaken us. And now it's going to be a battle between Pasm and Zygen. I can only fear Bambi is not realised that these two are actually gaining. If we look at last laps, Bambi 149.5 essentially. Pasm 149.2 and Zygen got held up actually. 150. Rounded those times, of course. Don't panic. I can read it was a 149.9, but it's a late 9, so we'll call it 50. Oh, this race is getting ever so exciting. Bambi has to pit this lap. He looks like he's a bit further to the right on the map. Bambi is pitting! Okay, now it gets exciting. Is Bambi going to come out ahead or behind Pasm? It's going to be very, very close. I think Zygen's going to come out ahead of Bambi. Now, they went into the pits. Zygen and Bambi were close, but I think Zygen's done enough on this second run, or second round of the race, to actually get ahead. Bambi still hasn't left his pit box yet. And Zygen comes round. So Zygen's definitely through. Pasm's definitely through. And Oz is making his pit stop now. Bambi with a lot of work to do, but he will have the better tyres. This is going to be so close coming to the last 11 minutes of the race. Who is going to win this race? Zygen currently has the advantage. But I imagine Bambi's got some crazy work to do now to catch up to Pasm and overtake him. Definitely lost a lot of positions. And Oz is dropping down the field now. And if we jump to Oz, is Oz going to stay ahead of Mies Vets? No, Oz is now at the back. Again, it's been detrimental to stay out that extra few laps to both Bambi and Oz that they've actually fallen behind. The bonus is they'll have better tyres, so we'll have to see how that works out coming into the final few laps of the race. We're all quite spread out at the moment, I think. If we have a look at times, yeah, we're all 1 or 2 seconds spread between each of us. Big gap between 4th and 3rd, of course. But DEPR has definitely made ground on Sig there. And we'll just jump a bit further to the front of the queue with Pasm and Zygen, because these two are very close. Looks like Zygen's pulling a bit of a gap. Go to TV camera. Let's have a bit of some nice shots. And we'll have a look at the map. We've got a couple of arrows that are fairly close to each other. Closer than these guys, actually. So let's jump to those. Is that Fisher? That is Fisher. Now, Fisher is catching Sig then. And he's very close. Now, he could have a good slipstream on the home straight. He's definitely catching, though. Definitely catching. So it's going to be Lexus versus Subaru once again. We had that the first few races here at the Red Bull Ring, and it was always epic. But Fisher's now going to have to slipstream on this straight, and this is going to be very close going into the chicane. They could work together, you know. If Sig and Fisher work together, they could catch DEPR and have a really good battle for fourth. So if you flick between the two cars, Fisher's got the speed. He's definitely catching. Under braking. Look at the gap just narrowed. Look at that. Fisher is on fire here. Right behind him now. Roma's just made a move on JF Rod 52 in the chicane. I can see it in the background. But we're going to jump to Fisher. We're going to jump to this camera. Let's have a look. If don't know why I look behind. That's just habit. But we're going to look at Fisher and Sig as they come into the second chicane. Is he going to go for a move on the inside? Brake slightly earlier. Not confident being behind the car. Got Lesmo 1 and 2 now. Is he going to make a move here? That would be an interesting move. No, it doesn't go for it. Of course, that that incident with Meisterfetz is probably in the back of his mind a little bit. Don't want to go 2 or 3 wide in there. Now, has he got momentum here? Doesn't look like it. Looks like Sig has the advantage, but we're going to have slipstream coming into the... Oh, he's got it now. Sig, he's on the left-hand side. Fisher on the right. And Fisher's cleanly got through there. Unless he goes for a really late breaking move. Doesn't. Fisher gets fifth place. Now he's got a lot of work to do to catch up to DPR in the remaining 7 minutes and 40 seconds. But is Sid going to come back? Remember, it's got slipstream, so we've got a long straight, we've got the Parabolica, and then we've got another long straight. Is Sid going to come back at Fisher? Doesn't. So Fisher keeps it. We're going to stay with Fisher just a little bit longer, and then we're going to jump to the Roma JF Rod 52 battle, as they're still at it. JF Rod 52's just taken Roma. Ah, but Roma's taking it back, so they must have been side by side. We'll definitely jump to that battle in a minute. We'll jump to that battle now, actually, then. As we jump to JF Rod 52. Now chasing Roma. Both Lexuses. So this is purely about slipstream and whether the downforce is higher or lower on the car at certain areas of the track. JF Rod going to the inside for the first chicane. Who's going to break later? Oh, JF Rod breaks much later. Runs a little bit deep. Is Roma going to go for the undercut? Roma's a bit sideways. And JF Rod 52 gets that position. Now this battling could bring Dutchy into the mix. Dutchy is going to be catching these guys. If you have a look at times, Dutchy ran a 149.4. Roma and JF Rod were in the 150s, so Dutchy's catching. Pasm's ran a 148.5. Last lap, Pasm, 148.5. He is catching Zygen. Zygen's trying to pull a gap as well, 148.6. Can't do it. And Pasm is now 2 seconds behind Zygen. And this could be a finale and a half for these final few laps. Some epically fast laps going on here. DEPR 148.9 as well. And Fisher 149.0. Some very close battles. But we're on the Roma and JF Rod 52 battle at the moment. We'll follow JF Rod 52 and Roma. You can see Roma catching from the slipstream. I think these two will be at it till the end of the race, I think. Oh, the slight contact! Ooh, contact under braking. And JF Rod 52 keeps the position. Roma's definitely wanting his position. Now you can tell with the way he's driving, he wants his position. JF Rod 52 goes for the defensive move for the Parabolica. Roma's going for the left-hand side of JF Rod 52. Oh, goes for a really late braking move. Oh, he's gone wide. He's gone off. Roma's gone off. And that means Dutchy goes through. And unlucky for Roma. In fact, Meisterfetz also goes through. And he's going to have to be careful of Oz, because he's going to have no momentum down here. If you look at the speed, Meisterfetz is up at 145. Oh, he is caught up a little bit now, but Oz must be getting in the slipstream. He must be catching. If we go to Oz, yes, he's definitely got more speed. Unlucky for Roma, he so badly wanted that. Didn't quite come off, and he's lost a few positions there. So let's jump back up to the front of the grid. Pasm. Now this is our championship leader, remember. He's currently in second place. So there's more points haul for him. He's ahead of Bambi, which is where he wants to be. In fact, Bambi is not catching. So Bambi has really lost out on strategy there. But it doesn't look like Pasm's catching enough to catch Zygen. Zygen has to make a mistake for Pasm to catch. So if we jump to the times, last lap, they essentially equaled each other. We know the gap was 2 seconds. It's down to 1.7 at the moment. And we'll have a look at the end of this lap to see what the gap is actually. Everyone is fairly spread out now. So it's purely about this winning or leading battle. Whether Pasm can catch Zygen in the last. Let's try and work this out. We're going to have at least... So we've got one more full lap after this. And then another one. And then it's going to be... I think that might be it. Yes, it's got this one and one more lap, I believe. So two laps for Pasm to gain on Zygen. If you have a look at the times, it's still 1.7. Pasm was slightly faster on that lap. So he is still catching. Bambi is now on a mission, obviously. His tyres are coming into play. I think he pitted two laps too late, did Bambi. I don't think he's got enough to try and catch them. DPR is still in fourth place, followed by Fisher. And we're going to jump back to lifetime. I keep jumping back and forward to these, but we need to try and find out where these battles are happening. Pasm is now 1.4 seconds down. Oh, this could be very close. If he gets in the 1 second, he's going to catch extremely quickly. And this is the battle we want to be on. We'll go for some TV shots for now. Let's see if Pasm's making any mistakes. This is why he's a championship leader. He doesn't make mistakes. Oh, it's going to be very close on the final laps. So we definitely have one more lap after this. And then we could have one more after that. Could be lucky to pass him. The fact that he's pushing Zygen means that he's going to have to go all out, which potentially pushes them onto another lap. In fact, they are definitely going to have two more laps. Pasm has got to go all out now to try and get this win. It could be very, very closest. I'm all excited for these last two laps to see this battle for first place. Zygen and Pasm. Now, they had their battles at Red Bull Ring. So the fact they're still battling here shows you how close this racing actually is. And you can just see Bambi in the distance there. A little bit too far away. Pasm is definitely gaining on Zygen. Let's have a look at the braking area. Oh, they're so close. Okay, so let's go jump back to the timings. So it's up at 1.6, apparently, the timings. That could be just due to the fact that Zygen's got better straight line speed, perhaps. Everybody in the 1:48s last lap. The speed of these guys at the moment is absolutely insane. The gap, 1.5 seconds. Oh, it's going to be close. Pasm has to get into that slipstream. He'll be biting. He'll just want to get in. He's just biting the air. He's chewing it. Go on, get me closer. Gets in that 1 second. He'll be gaining at a very fast pace of knots. But they come on this, call this the back straight. And he's got to try and do something. He's got to go for a few risks here. He's got enough of a gap to Bambi to make a few risks. But we'll have to see. Meisterfetz has just made a move on Dutchy. I believe that was at the chicane. They're still side by side. If we can jump to that quickly. Meisterfetz and Dutchy. Meisterfetz trying to make up lost ground. We've got Roma back in the action. So Roma's going to have to try and get past Dutchy. Now remember, Roma made the mistake at the Parabolica. He's going to go for a similar move again. Try and avoid that mistake this time, though, at the Parabolica. But Dutchy's got a bit of help off slipstream here. Is Dutchy going to go for a move on Meisterfetz? Staying behind. He's looking aggressive. He's having a look. Doesn't go for it. Stays behind now. Oh, Roma goes very late into the braking. I'm not sure whether there was contact there. I know he tried to avoid it, but I'm not sure whether there was initial contact. And all positions stay the same, but that was very, very close. So is Roma going to go for it on the last lap as well? So we've got two battles at the moment. And luckily for Dutch... Oh, that was definitely contact. Definite contact. Dutchy stays on the track. As does Roma, but now they're going to have the slipstream. I want to have a look at the timings. It doesn't look like Pasm's going to have enough here on the final lap. The arrows are still too far apart. Meisterfetz goes to the right-hand side. What's happened to Meisterfetz? His fuel is so low. Look at his fuel. And Roma goes for the inside on Dutchy. He's got the inside. Oh, he's got it. Oh, he's trying to be too deep, though. Oh, that was very close. Roma's having a bit of a dodgy exit as well. Dutch is still on the inside. Meisterfetz is really low on fuel. Roma has plenty. Dutchy has just enough for this lap. But Meisterfetz is just going for slipstream. It's going to be so close if he even makes it to the end. Oz could get in position. Dutchy going for the move on Roma. Doesn't quite work out. And Roma keeps it. Roma's a bit all over. Dutchy picking up a bit of the gravel as well. If you go for the timings, Pasm has not got enough. So let's jump to Pasm. Zygen, sorry. Let's jump to Zygen. As he's about to come round and finish, we have a look for Pasm. He's just outside. We can see Zygen flashing his lights. He knows he's done it. He knows he's won this race. And Zygen is your race winner. First race at Monza, and that is Zygen, followed by Pasm, followed by Bambi with, I think his tactics let him down there for Bambi. Then a DEPR in fourth place, on his own, in the middle of nowhere. Nobody in sight, in fact, and DEPR is about to come in fourth place. Jump to Fischer, 11th to 5th, he can't complain. Fifth place, what a position there for Fischer. Sig in sixth place. Only Fischer ahead of him. Fischer did make some ground from Sig there. JF Rod, 52, in 7th place. Roma's taken Dutchy on the last lap. So Roma and Dutchie, and Meisfeld is coming back out. Dutchie, look at that fuel! Look at the fuel! There's none left. He was on fumes. But he does make it. That slipstream must have helped him on the last part of that. Oh, that was so close. But what a race there by everybody. What a race. And we'll jump to the final results in just 1 second. When it all loads. But what a race. We'd pass him. Unlucky there not to get in the slipstream. Zagan just kept the gap. And the little Zagan was very happy coming across the line, flashing his lights. As the room loads now. So we'll just wait for the results to come in. What a race. What a race. Bit further spread out, but there were some epic battles. There was a big incident with Meisterfetz at Lesmo 1. But I think Bambi's tactics let him down there. Bambi needed that win. And unfortunately, he hasn't got it. So we'll see what car he picks for race 2. Be very interesting. A few great races and great wins coming out there in the chat, as you can see. So we're still just waiting for the results to load. Give it a few more seconds. Roma obviously very happy there. Roma's obviously had some epic battles throughout that. Mistake at Parabolica cost him a few positions there. He was having a battle with JF Rod 52. As we just wait for it to load. It's nearly there. We're off the black screen on the centre screen, which means we're nearly there. Does take quite a while though. And there we go. So let's just save the replay. And we've got our evidence. And I'm not making the same mistake. Here are the race results then. So we have Zygen coming in for the win on 17 laps. Then our GTP passed him 1.1 seconds. He was just outside that gap. I mean, Zygen may have taken it easy on the last lap a little bit just to end the gap shortened, but just 1 second, he was so close. Now that could be bat markers when he pitted and others hadn't yet. That could have that anything that could have been. Then have Bambi in third place, final of the podium positions. Those three in a world of their own there up front. We then have DEPR in 4th place, Fisher in 5th, what a race from Fisher. 6th, we have the SIG, 27.7 seconds behind, JF Rod in 7th, then have Roma in 8th, unlucky for Roma. 9th, we have Dutchy, then Meisterfetz coming in on fumes basically, and then we have GTPRs. What a race, what a lot, chaos is what I will call that, chaos. Lots of tactics, lots of fighting, and a few incidents here and there. Hello everyone and welcome to the Room B of the Monza first race. We saw Room A, this is the highlights of Room B, and we're on the pole position person, which is GTP Mad Max, who did one race at Red Bull Ring. Then have Patrick in second, Mr. Racing Line in third, followed by GTP Garatron in fourth place. He's highlighted yellow on the list of names because we're using his replay. Then have Nail, Jay Vitoni, Jamcar1, and I'm going to call him Ha. He was in 8th place. Just for ease. So once just had a jump start there at the back. Mad Max gets set off. Has a quite solid start. Mr. Racing Line coming for the attack but can't get past. And that's GTP Patrick boxing him in as well. Oh, Gravitron's coming to the right hand side. We're coming to the first chicane. Who's going to have the position to go through? Mr. Racing Line hits Mad Max. Mad Max goes straight into the barrier. And Mr. Racing Line coming out the chicane. Gravitron side by side goes into the gravel. Oh, bit mayhem there. We're going to jump to Gravitron's going a bit slowly. We've got Nail side by side, further back. Cat and Mad Max are side by side as well. As they come around the Curva Grande and head towards the second chicane. It looks like Mr. Racing Line has the lead and Nail is in third place behind Gravitron. As we get there, there's still a battle a bit further behind. They've settled positions. Everyone's in single file now as we come through there. And Mr. Racing Line taking that lead. Oh, that's Mad Max has just taken Hat again. Further back in fifth place if we go there now. And it looks like he's running good and running wide. And Vitoni's going to get this place as well. Side by side with Hat. Vitoni does get it. Going into the second Lesmo. And indeed he does. So that's Vitoni up to fifth place. Hat is down into sixth place. And Mad Max has a lot of work to do to get back up to his first place position where he started. So they come up to... Oh, we've got a bit of action further down. Vitoni, Hat, and Patrick won. Coming to the Ascari. Oh, three wide coming into Ascari and has lost even more places. Patrick overtakes two drivers Vittoni back down into 6th, but Patrick goes from 7th to 5th. What a move by Patrick! As they head towards the Parabolica now, looks like there's some action a bit further forward. That's Mad Max overtaking Nail for 3rd place, and Mad Max definitely on a mission here to reclaim that. Oh! Someone's run wide, that's Mad Max locking his brakes. Manages to just stay on at the Parabolica, but Nail's going to have a run on him, coming down the start-finish straight, and heading towards the start of the second lap, and the first chicane. As we will have a look now to see if he does get his position. We head towards the first chicane, he goes for the inside, he's looking, is he going to go for it? Mad Max outbreaks Nail, so Mad Max keeps that third place, Nail in fourth, Patrick in fifth, already built the gap to Vittoni, who's in sixth place. We then have Hart in seventh and Jankar one in eighth place. We will go to Gravitron now and have a look and see if Mad Max can make this position up very quickly. Might be slightly worried about Patrick and can see him in the mirrors. The fact that Patrick's also moving up very quickly. So Mad Max gets a run on Gravitron, coming out of Lesmo 2, side by side now as they head towards the Ascari section. Patrick's still not side by side with Nail yet, so Mad Max making a position, does move up to second place. Is he going to outbreak Gravitron coming to this section? He does indeed. Mad Max up to second place after that start. He's definitely on a mission. Further back, we then have Nail and Patrick. We'll see if Patrick can make any progress. Nail doesn't use a lot of the track there, so Patrick does get a bit of a run. Coming up to the Parabolica, is Patrick going to go to the... He doesn't go to the right side. Ooh, we've got somebody very wide at the back. That looked like but Patrick is through to fourth place and has easily got that at the Parabolica. So Patrick up to fourth and is going to head towards Gravitron to try and get that third place. Does look like Nail is catching Gravitron there as well. It looks like Nail could. Oh, Nail's off at the first chicane. Nail's definitely lost speed there. Vittoni doesn't use all the exit of the track there. Needs to get that into check. Maybe even try and catch Mad Max at a missed racing line, but we will see. Coming into this Gravitron section, Gravitron runs really wide. Patrick gets third place. Wasn't much Patrick had to do there. Just the pressure was enough on Gravitron for Gravitron to make the mistake. Mad Max using all the track there. Gets a good run on Mr. Racing Line on the exit of Lesmo 2. And they're going to be side by side as they come up to the Ascari section. Ooh, it's going to be very close. Looks like Mad Max on the outside. Is he going to be able to do this? He's going to have to outbreak Mr. Racing Line really late. Doesn't do it. Mr. Racing Line keeps that position. As we'll jump onto the third eye camera. You can see how much Mad Max gains on the exit. He's got the momentum coming down the left-hand side of Mr. Racing Line. Mad Max is going to get this, but he's on the outside for Parabolica. He'll have to get past Mr. Racing Line before he gets there. Otherwise, he might have to settle for second again. Ooh, he breaks really late. Mad Max takes that position, and he regains the lead. But Mr. Racing Line is going to have the slipstream on the start-finish straight. Is he going to retake the position for first? As we will begin to see him start catching. You can see it now. You can see the speed difference. Slipstream having a big effect here. As they come up to... Oh, he's just let off. He wants to stay in second. Very interesting tactic by Mr. Racing Line. This could be some form of strategy for tyres and fuel, of course. But we will see. Perhaps doesn't want to fight. Doesn't want Patrick to catch up. Where is Patrick? Quite far away yet. Oh, we've got our first pit stop. Mr. Mad Max is in the pit. So that means we will see a true gap of these two drivers. Mr. Racing Line doing his fastest lap. He needed that and has actually gained 8 tenths over GTP Patrick 1. Mr. Racing Line definitely needed that. We've also got Gravitron in the pit. And nobody else has gone in yet. So we are around the pit stop window, you know, 15 minutes being halfway, so he's coming a lap early as Mad Max and Gravitron. We'll see if it is an advantage to those drivers later on in the race. Mad Max already heading out the pits. He's actually going to be met by, is it Jamcar 1? It is indeed, but he just gets ahead of Jamcar 1, so it shouldn't hold him up too much and should be already racing out in front. In fact, further back, Gravitron hasn't come out in front of Ha. And this is going to be a battle for position unless Ha doesn't hold him up, knowing that Gravitron has already done his pit stop. Remember, all drivers have to have this pit stop. We will wait and see. Gravitron getting a run already on the Curva Grande on the Ha in the RX-7. As they head towards the second chicane, Ha moving to the left-hand side. Is he defending? Is he letting off? He's defending that position, so this is going to hold Gravitron up. This is going to affect the fourth place battle. between Gravitron, Nail and Vitone, we will have to wait and see, but he's definitely being held up at the moment. They come through Lesmo 1. And Hai still not moving out of the way, so definitely fighting for position. He has every right to. It's not a lap car. It is for position, but it's not really for net position. We've Hai still having to pit, so we'll have to wait and see. As Graviton's going to have a run, coming up to the Ascari section. Is he going to go for a dive bomb down the inside? He needs to get past as fast as he can, because this will be costing him time. As we have, I believe Patrick's in the pits now. Oh, Hai gets it all wrong at the start of that section. Cost Graviton a little bit more of time. This racing line carries on, so a bit of strategy coming in here. Patrick pitting earlier. Looks like Nail's in the pits. And it looks like Vitone's in the pits as well. And Mad Max obviously is already pitted. Jam Car 1 carries on. And Hart is looking for the pits, I think. He is indeed, so it's not going to hold Gravitron up anymore. Gravitron using all the slipstream at the exit. And is Gravitron going to lose 4th place here? Nope, Nail's still in the pits. So Gravitron does keep that net 4th place. Remember, Jam Car 1 has not pitted. Mr. Racing Line hasn't pitted, but I believe he'll be so far ahead. Already doing Lesmo 2 and heading towards the Ascari section. So everybody spreads out again a little bit. So far not moving to the outside. So far he's carrying on. But Patrick does have a bit of slipstream here. Patrick should get past. Jam Car 1 doesn't pit. Wonder what the tactics are for this. I wonder who he's trying to beat. Mr. Racing Line hasn't pitted either yet, which is very interesting. But Patrick up to 3rd place. I believe that's where he should be at the moment. But if we have a look at lap times, we have... Mr. Racing Line has put in another fastest lap, so Mr. Racing Line is definitely on for it. But of course, the fastest lap of the race is Mad Max, who's just done it on the last lap. So Mad Max definitely looking for the win here, with a 149.1 streaked ahead of everybody else. Oh, Mr. Racing Line already heading out here. Wow, he has pulled a serious gap. In fact, to be racing Mad Max. This is a surprise. There's Mad Max. There's Mr. Racing Line. So has definitely pulled some time back here somehow. Even though Mad Max was on the flyer, Mad Max must have known. And Mr. Racing Line comes out in 2nd place, miles ahead of Patrick. Jam Car 1's also pitted now as well. Oh, Mad Max running wide there. The exit of the second chicane, losing a lot of time and speed. Hopefully he's definitely pushing hard, is Mad Max. I'm not sure why he's pushing so hard. Mr. Racing Line obviously putting a bit of pressure on here that we can't fully digest how much pressure. Mr. Racing Line using all the exit there of Lesmo 2 as well. As we approach start finish line, you can see those arrows are getting closer and closer. And once again, Nail is in the 153s. Vitone is in the 152.5. He's 2.5 seconds behind. He's gaining around a second a lap. Second a lap. And puts him right on Nail's bumper as we come to the end of this race. Let's jump to Vitone now and watch this gap start to close. As we approach Lesmo 2. Again, Nails it well this time. Oh, that's the best I've seen him do, Lesmo 2. And look at the gap he gained to Nail as we head towards the Ascari section. He's definitely in the slipstream now as well. Oh, it's going to be a run down to the Parabolica and the start-finish line. Whether Nail or Vitone is going to get this position. I think Mad Max has finished. I think Mr. Racing Line has finished. And I think Patrick has just finished as well. And Gravitron's just coming out the Parabolica. Oh, Vitone loses it at Ascari. He's not going to catch Nail, unfortunately. So that's a Nail confirmed 5th place. We'll go and watch. Oh, in fact, he's got to be careful of Jam Car 1 here. Jam Car 1's just exited Ascari, but he's going to have so much more momentum coming down to the Parabolica. He could lose another position here, Vitone. Let's have a look at Jam Car 1. You can see he's 10 miles an hour faster. I think he's just too far behind. I mean, he stayed out a bit too long in that pit stop window, and he's not going to do this. But if he was slightly 1 second closer, and that could have been Jam Car 1 for 6th place. Fortunately, it isn't. It's going to be Jam Car 1 in 7th place, Vitone in 6th place, and Hai's already finished in 8th place after already being lapped. So we're just going to look at the final results for that Room B Race 1. and we can see Mad Max won the race, and he had a faster slap of a 1:48.8, really on the pace there. Followed by Mr. Racing Line in second place, it's good for him, with GTP Patrick 1 coming in third place after a good race as well from him. Gravitron, much better than the Red Bull Ring, comes in fourth place, well done Gravitron, followed by Nail in fifth place. Vittori in sixth place, that mistake right at the end, trying to chase Nail as hard as he could, but then nearly lost out to Jamcar 1, who finished in 7th place. 8th is Ha, who unfortunately was one lap down on the rest of the field. So that was your Room B race 1. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you at the next race. It's go, 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 they're going now, and they'll get a good start. Looks like Ziggen actually had a slightly better start than Pazza. Momentum, got the inside. Fallow takes.